Welcome everyone to my channel, YouTube Sergio Calle Perez, and invite you to subscribe but also click the bell in order to open notification for upcoming videos. The invitation of Jesus in the Gospel of St. Matthew chapter 11 is for each of one of us, believers and not believers, the opportunity to have another vision about the world, about our own life, about the daily events of a society. When Jesus says, "Come to me, all of you who have labored and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart." Listen, learn from me. That lesson is for everyone. Because if you follow this rule, you are able to live in the middle of your family, in the middle of society, in every circumstances, and overcoming. Because Jesus will teach you, and you can learn from this kind of teaching. Since you practice being meek and humble of heart, but also finding rest in Jesus. Finding rest in Jesus also means try to find the answer of every circumstances of a state in your life. He said, "For my yoke is easy and my burden light." What it means? Means that when you go to Jesus, every problem will be seen different. Even you don't find the answer for yourself immediately, in Jesus you can wait and be optimistic that we're talking about later on. He is referring to our teaching to be able to live in the community, be in family, work, or society. If each of us learns to live under the values that we have been talking about all these days, and we those of today, of knowing how to help others, being for them of support in their difficulties and their most overwhelming moments. This is what Jesus did by carrying our sins on his shoulders. You and I can also do the same, tolerate each other and allow inner peace to flourish, to establish the civilization of the new humanity, which lives in optimism. Today, I invite you to point to optimism in the midst of all your problems and many other situations that on a personal, family, community, on social level, they are happening, so that you're using your time, talents, and treasure, and we can build with the motto of optimism. Being optimistic is an act of having a favorable view of the events or conditions and expect the most favorable outcome. Demonstrating or reflecting a favorable view of events and conditions and the expectation of a positive outcome. Being pessimistic is the other way around. Being optimistic is good for you. Optimistic means because it's the keys of success and it gives you the meaning the one's life. Optimism lets a person gain confidence and brings positive change to one's mind so you can overcome your problems successfully. An optimistic person is one who never gets discouraged by any state of affairs but sets his or her mind positive rather than a negative, which in turn leads him or her to experience improvements. He or you, she is a person who knows for certain that whatever be the area of trouble, there may be positive or alternative ways through which he can come out from various difficult situations correctly. Be courageous. The prophet Joshua said, "Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Don't be afraid. Don't be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go." I pray for you, pray for me, may God bless you.